This is absolutely terrible news, I guess, if you're a fan of, kiddohood, adulthood, and that whole thing. Noel Clarke has been accused of being a little bit of a predator, a little bit of a creep, not a little bit, a pretty excessive one, right? 20 plus people, women actually, specifically, have come out and kind of cataloged a whole bevy of insurrections that he's kind of been insurrections. You know what I mean? Things that he's been basically doing behind the scenes that have maybe called into question, his entire legacy and what he's done for movies in the UK in general. And again, as a fan of the movies that he's put out in the past, it's obviously clearly disappointing. But as I've pointed out in a lot of these instances where people, high-ranking individuals within the entertainment industry, are being accused of being predators, I've always pointed out the fact that I think monsters, by and large, will always exist in society. I don't think we'll ever rid ourselves of people who take advantage of others in especially places or sectors like the entertainment industry, which by and large is kind of built on exploitation. There's always going to be somebody who's going to take it that bit further and kind of, use their power, influence, whatever it is, position that they have to gain whatever advantage or, to kind of scratch whatever desire that they want to have scratched. And unfortunately, the people on the lower rungs of that kind of level of influence and power are the ones that are going to be impacted the worst with that sort of thing. It won't really affect the higher ups because, someone like that isn't going to spoil or ruin their friendships or they burn their bridges by trying to abuse somebody that's actually in a position of power similar to theirs. They're always going to take advantage of somebody that they deem to be lower, which is obviously the lowest thing that you could ever do to somebody. With that being said, it is a responsibility of the industry itself to call out these people and hold them to account, which is why I would say, having read this whole entire article and a few of the other ones going forward, I'm under no illusion, in my opinion personally. I just don't think he did this sort of stuff without anybody knowing within the industry. I don't believe it. I think people knew. People kind of chose to turn a blind eye because at that moment in time, he was, hotter than flipping fish grease. He was one of the main people responsible for putting out certain type of movies and being behind a certain type of TV series that represented a certain type of people in the UK. And people wanted to align themselves with him because he had all the momentum and they didn't want to call it out because it served their purpose. It wasn't, it wasn't advantageous to their career prospects to be the one kind of calling him out for his disgusting behavior. So he was able to go on uncontested and inflict more and more pain to allegedly to more and more people over the years. And now we're in a position where it finally come to a head. But again, I wouldn't give any of these people pats on the back, especially the ones in the higher up positions for essentially coming forward and saying these things, because the ones that have been really affected, as you read the entire thing, are people who are kind of on the periphery of the industry, but also very important and vital to the scene. I did a couple of extra gigs, right? And I remember being in the changing rooms and doing hair and makeup and stuff and talking to the people behind the scenes. And usually they're very upfront about who's a dick and who isn't a dick. And it's a very kind of small world. They all know each other, right? They all kind of are familiar with who was on what and who did this, who did that. And word kind of travels very, very quickly. So I refuse to believe that this is some sort of new revelation. I'm sure people within the acting drama theater world had some inkling about Noel Clarke's alleged behavior, but they were unwilling to say something because at that time it served their purpose to kind of keep him sweet and to kind of, extract whatever value they could out of it for their own situation. So this is the article here from The Guardian. It says, obviously, as predator actor Noel Clarke accused of groping, harassment and bullying by 20 women. It says, when Noel Clarke appeared on stage at the Royal Albert Hall on 10th of April to collect his BAFTA, a typically self-assured actor looked a little on edge. Viewers might have concluded that Clarke was simply overwhelmed. He was clutching one of the precious accolades bestowed on him by the British Academy of Film, Television and Arts, the prize for outstanding British contribution to cinema. Yet there were other reasons why Clarke and BAFTA may have felt procured. preoccupied, sorry. 13 days before the presenting Clark with his award, the Guardian investigation can conveal BAFTA was informed about the existence of several allegations of verbal abuse, bullying, and harassment against Clark. BAFTA does not dispute it's received anonymous emails, reports, and allegations via intermediaries, but said that it was provided with no evidence that it would allow it to investigate. So again, they were sitting on their hands. They were kind of put, you know, the evidence was put forward to them, but instead of investigating it, they wanted to be held, you know, by the hand, similar to DSP when he's playing his games online, and they went to be held, you know, handholded throughout the entire process in order to kind of get some sort of justice for the victims. And obviously you can see Noel Clark's face there, a face of somebody that probably is of the knowledge that, you know, things are going to go tumbling down from this moment on. I'm curious. I would love to be a fly on the wall to some of these instances where people get cancelled in this way. What that must do to your psyche, what that must do to your family, to your immediate circle of friends, and what actually happens. Do your phone calls suddenly stop getting answered? Does your wife take the kids away and go to a hotel? Are you punching the wall? Are you screaming into a pillow? Like, when you know that this is going to be happening, or when it actually does happen and the articles are out there, it must be one of the worst positions to be in. And I guess if you're a victim of some of these crimes, that must bring some level of satisfaction, because I don't know what could be done with some of the allegations in terms of criminal offenses, but I guess one of the only sort of bits of solace you can glean from this, if you're a victim allegedly of the crimes that he allegedly done, is that he's really suffering right now. He's going through it. The turmoil that he's suffering from is probably unparalleled when it comes to where he was and where he's going to be for the future going forward, because as per usual, even if he's found innocent, the fact that he's accused of these things is bad enough for his entire reputation to be in complete tatters. So this is a wild situation, right? To go from that to suddenly have this article put out about you. God almighty, how the mighty fall, innit? Clark also became aware of the allegations, which he vehemently denies. As he stepped on stage holding his gong, Clark's reputation remained publicly unblemished, not as just an actor, producer, screenwriter and director, but also one who could claim to be one of British film and television's most lauded stars. The about decision to venerate Clark moved numerous women to break their silence. They allege Clark is a serial abuser of women, using his power in the industry to prey on and harass female colleagues, and sometimes bully those who fall out of favor, which is why sometimes it's hard, and which is why, even though I'm not a fan of this trial by social media crap that's going on at the moment, I do think if he's accused of these crimes, he should be held to account and go to a court of law, and, you know, they should be able to decide what his punishment should be. But you can't just be putting out articles about people and have their entire lives be taken away from them. But the other thing why I kind of do sometimes think they do kind of serve a greater good is that sometimes, even if a story gets put out that maybe isn't the most factually correct, maybe there's some instances that aren't the most, you know, watertight, and maybe a few accounts are a bit shaky and people just clout chasing or just wanting the attention, because I'm sure that happens. If you're there's 10 accusers who come forward, you know, it's not victim blaming by saying that potentially there could be two or three in there who are just completely talking out of their ass. What actually does happen, though, with the story being put out, is that girls who are not kind of confident and weren't really brave enough to step forward at first might gain that confidence when they see those stories and be like, oh, I recognize parts and pieces of these accounts from things that happened to me, and then they're willing to step forward. So if you're the one being accused of these things, the worst thing by and large is obviously to be accused. You don't ever want to be somebody that's, you know, being thought of as a creep or a predator, because more likely than not, if you have other demons in your closet, they're also going to come out. It's just inevitable. Someone else is going to say, hey, this and this happened to me, and then suddenly it's gone from being, you know, 20 people to 55, you know what I mean, and then you're looking absolutely wild out here. So it continues here. We can read some of the allegations. Okay, so this is the first one, and maybe one that kind of gives you an idea of like why this is probably something that I've always been really disgusted with when it comes to people that do this sort of stuff, because it obviously involves people who are not in a position to kind of, I wouldn't say argue, but not in a position to kind of stand up for themselves, especially in the entertainment industry, because it's predatory, right? The entertainment industry is exploitive. They do kind of, you know, actors and whatever, performers are having to sing and dance for their, basically, for their supper. They're having to, you know, for lack of a better term, kiss people's asses in order to get a job, in order to be considered for a job, in order to get into certain rooms. So because of that, it just gives It gives the breathing room and it gives the kind of field for absolute creepos to come in there and take advantage. And it's always the ones that get affected are the ones that are always, you know, on the come up, or people that are just on the outskirts. For instance, on this report, there's producers here, there's assistant directors, there's so many different people who are kind of integral to kind of keeping that entire ecosystem of the, you know, entertainment industry running, TV, film, movies and stuff, who are also kind of dependent on this stuff as an actual job and working as an actual career, who have probably suffered other bits of harassment and abuse throughout their time in it. It's just so frustrating that you'd want to do this to these kind of people, because they're the ones that glue this scene together, that glue the industry together, don't get me wrong. And I've only known this for a brief period of time being an extra, of how important these people are and how important it is that you treat them with respect. But you know, some people just take the piss out of their position. So it continues. This is the one that says, this is one of the accounts. Prolific and influential filmmaker. So Clark is one of the most prolific actors and filmmakers in the UK. Skip that. Clark writes and executive produces the stars alongside Ashley Waters in Bulletproof, one of Sky's biggest shows. Series 4 is in pre-production. His other company, Unstoppable Film and Television. I'm speaking so shit right now. Please forgive me for reading out loud really crappily. It continues. Really badly. He's produced more than 10 films in addition to Bulletproof and a Channel 5 drama, The Drowning. He is on the BAFTA Influential Film Committee and is a mentor for ITV, bringing him into contact with young aspiring screenwriters. Only this week, Clark has been starring in ITV's new flagship prime drama, Viewpoint, airing each evening, Monday to Friday. Gianna Powell worked with Carl as a producer between September 2014 and March 2017 during Brotherhood. She told The Guardian that Clark would constantly harass her, on one occasion telling her that when he hired her, he had planned to F her and fire her. So I guess this is this type of humor and banter and jokes, which is weird when you consider that supposedly their relationship was based on mentorship. He kind of helped her get into some drama school or something, and then from there kind of basically guided her through her career, so and so. So basically acted like a big brother, and then suddenly this brother is basically telling you that he wants to, you know, get up to any sorts of business with you in there. So that's when you know somebody is already a bit of a wrong one from that alone. She also alleges that Clark would brag about storing sexually explicit pictures and videos on his hard drive, including footage he told her he'd secretly filmed during naked auditions. Do you know how maddening that must be? Like, if you're an actor, that you have somebody out there potentially keeping up footage of you that's been filmed without your permission, especially when you're naked. God almighty. Powell says that Clark once showed her secretly recorded video on one such audition with Jana James, an actor in Brotherhood. Powell said that Powell told four people about Clark's alleged secret filming, all of whom confirmed the conversations with The Guardian. They include James, her friend, whom she told about the incident in the winter of 2017 in the pub of South London. So it's obviously corroborating the account that it actually happened, that conversation. The naked audition had taken place more than 4 years previously from the film Legacy. Powell also was able to describe the exact haircut James had at the time. Her hair is usually long and blonde, but after a hairdresser disaster, she had cropped it short and returned to her natural brown. So if ever there was any sort of, you know, confusion or doubt as to whether or not he has this alleged footage on his phone or somewhere within his possession, which I would allege if he did have it, it's probably been destroyed by now. This was it. The person was able to kind of say exactly what that girl's haircut was like because of something that she hasn't necessarily worn. Maybe something that's never been on social media. Like, that must be chilling. James recalls Clark had talked her into auditioning for the role. She had been hesitant. She was only 23 and fresh out of drama school, but Clark persuaded her, explaining that the naked audition wouldn't be filmed, and an email from her agent confirmed this agreement. So do you know, and again, this is what I'm saying to you about, monsters exist, but the institutions that they exist in are what help and abet, they basically aided abet them in doing their heinous crimes. An agent was contacted that one of their clients would be going into an audition which required them to be naked, and they agreed because what they wanted their 10 to 15%. That's who you really have to look at. The industry overall that kind of perpetuated this nonsense. Horrendous, horrendous. She said, I was told 100% it was not going to be on camera, James says. As she understood it, the naked audition was purely to check that she could do the scene and wasn't going to bottle it on the day. Hopefully she kind of fired this agent as well, this girl. I hope she has. The audition was mortifying, James recalls. After she pulled out of the running for the role, she didn't want one of her first acting jobs to be nude. The Guardian spoke to two friends of Power and James who were also present in the pub that day and recalled the emotional exchange. She said, I was so upset. Now, years later, I still cry when I talk about it. And imagine the conflicting emotions that she's going through at that time. This is Noel Clark, somebody that's very influential, very popular, has the ability to kind of greenlit, you know, a bit of a, what's that word called? There's a term for it. But anyway, he's able to greenlit many different projects, and you're somebody on the come up. You know how difficult it is to even get a job, let alone to kind of, you know, audition for one or to be in a certain room for one, and you get given an opportunity, a layup, and all you have to do is take your clothes off. All you had to do was just take your clothes off. There must be a weird conundrum going on in your head where you're thinking, if I just do this, this could really change my life. This could maybe allow me to kind of retire my mum, buy a house, get my first car, you pay for the wedding, right? There's so many things on your mind that are like, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. And then you turn it down and you generally think you might have ruined your career because you're thinking, how about if this is what everyone does and I'm just dumb enough to think that I'm somehow exempt from doing that sort of thing? But then, you know, luckily, as time has progressed, you know, she's been okay. She's been able to do other jobs. And it's basically been proven that this guy was a creep. But imagine at that time what that must have felt like to go through. Such a crisis in your career. Do you know what I mean? And all because somebody that you kind of actually loved and thought that was actually here to support you has put you in that position. It's really inexcusable. It continues. It says, Clark denies covertly filming naked auditions or sharing such footage with Powell. A casting director who was present at James' audition said that there was absolutely no way Clark would have covertly filmed it, even without her knowledge. That's interesting. If he's got the footage, maybe that's, you know, one of his friends backing him up. He said he's always been a good guy. She said the Guardian also contacted others who worked with Clark who either declined to comment or spoke positively of him. They included a makeup artist who said that she had a really good relationship working with Clark. No one wanted to put their names on record though on the projects that worked together, and an actor who said suggestions of misconduct did not tally with his experience with Clark being generous and supportive. Others have said Clark was supportive to fellow actors, but at times sought to exploit their relationship, which is hallmarks of an absolute creep. Clark helped James get into drama school when she was 22. See what I mean? So she was fresh out of drama school when she was 23. So this is a year later and he's already doing this nonsense. He secured a discount on her fees after she finished the summer 2012. She says Clark joked about going upstairs to have S with her in a hotel where they were meeting. She believes she and other alleged victims were young and naive when Clark gave them professional opportunities, and that's why it was taking so long to come out. Clark and James were initially reticent about making complaints against a man they believed wields considerable power in the industry. Despite this, Clark and James and several women of The Guardian spoke to have agreed to go on a record. Others include well-known actors, which remain anonymous. Their pseudonyms are marked with asterisks. The women work in almost every level of film. That's what I'm saying. Every level making the hierarchy and represent the large range of races and ethnicities. Absolutely heinous. But that being said, I think there is a development now. Obviously, BAFTA suspends him over the allegations, which is, you know, again, flipping diabolical. Don't give him any props. They knew of these allegations prior and still allowed him to get up on stage and claim the prize. If he's accused of what he's accused of and it's true, that already is a crime in itself. And then you've got here a report from the BBC saying a report made to police about allegations against the actor. So some people are obviously going ahead with police complaints towards him. But the most heinous thing, I think, has been some of his colleagues that he's worked with closely who have now come out and decided to kick him whilst he's down, when knowing full well, I would assume, my understanding, especially from being within my little industry in streetwear, in fashion, in, you know, dance music, you hear things about people. It is what it is when you go out enough and you're around certain people. I don't think that this was some sort of secret that no one was aware of, that some guy that, you know, was always a nice guy and no one knew he was bad was doing these things in secret. I refuse to believe it. I think everybody heard some kind of rumor. No one wanted to maybe, you know, confront it because, you know, it wasn't their business and didn't want to get involved. But I refuse to believe that this is this. Everyone sort of learned about this. That's in the industry from the Guardian article. I refuse. And one of these people is this girl called Michaela Cole, who obviously has a TV series here in the UK. I forgot what it was called. Something about her getting date raped. I forgot the series. Anyway, it's meant to be really good. I haven't checked it out, but she put a statement here saying, "I'm here to offer great support." I think she's a co-star as well of Noel Clarke in another series too. She said, "I'm here to offer support for the 20 brave women who have come forward, those who have shared their identities with us, but also those who have preferred to use aliases. The mental hurdles and black women must overcome to do such thing as to reveal their identity within a narrative of our abuse and bullying at the hands of somebody within our community can sometimes be too much. Speaking out about these instances takes a lot of strength because some call them grey areas. They are, however, far from grey. These behaviours are unprofessional, violent, and can destroy a person's perception of themselves, their place in the world, and their career irreparably. I have shared to show solidarity, to express my belief that in them and to stand with them in their indignation. I applaud The Guardian and its journalists for investigating and publishing this story." Again, I just don't think that she had no idea. It's just my own opinion. Don't shoot me for it, but I just think people within the industry knew that what was going on and decided to turn a blind eye because that guy was hotter than fish grease, and it is what it is, isn't it? And unfortunately, the ones who had to suffer were these people who worked in every rung of the film industry, who are basically coming across a guy who had, you know, inexplicable power, who was able to kind of influence and change the narrative on certain things, you know, paint you out to be a crazy person, victim shame, whatever it may be. But I just refuse to believe that none of these co-stars or people within the industry knew what was going on, and it's despicable that they were coming again. All these people, fair enough, they got families, and you know, this guy just bought a mansion and shit. But is there not a position that you could be in if you're somebody's friend and somebody gets accused of something like this, where you just say, "This person's obviously a close friend of mine who I've done a lot of work with. Although the allegations are heinous, there are allegations at the moment, and I'm going to refuse to publicly chastise my friend until we've really come to a point where, you know, court proceedings are, whatever's happened, and then I'll make another statement." Isn't that allowed? Like I mentioned before, what's his name? The guy that did the Hateful Eight. What's his name? What's that guy's name? The Hateful Eight guy. What's his name? What's his name? Yeah, Quentin Tarantino. I mentioned this a few times on here before, but Quentin Tarantino was very close with Harvey Weinstein. I'm imagining Lionsgate, the company that Harvey founded, was responsible for producing a lot of the films that he put out. And when the allegations came out about Harvey Weinstein, even Quentin Tarantino said something along the lines of like, "Hey, he's my friend, and although the allegations are horrible, I'm going to, you know, withhold from passing judgment until there's more evidence put out there," and whatever it may be. And then when obviously the court proceedings came and all that malarkey and more accounts, he then came back out another statement and said, obviously, you know, "I don't endorse any of this nonsense, and I'm here with the victims." But he was able to say like, "Hey, this guy's my friend. I'm not going to come and just bury them off the back of one article that's been published in The Guardian." Regardless of how horrendous it is, there's still a little bit of loyalty that has to be kind of put forward when somebody's your friend. Now, someone can say, "Hey, there's no loyalty when your friend is a rapist, allegedly, or does those sort of things." I get it. But God damn it, this industry is foul, isn't it? You're up and then everyone's your friend, and then the moment one allegation comes out, they all kind of scutter into their little bunkers and throw out statements saying that they had no idea what you were like. Like, come on, you really had no idea what I was like? Really? Really? Let's continue. "My thoughts are with the women." This is from Ashley Waters, Asha D. He says, "My thoughts are with the women who've come forward and told their awful stories. I'm in shock and deeply saddened by what has heard in multitude of levels. I would never condone behavior of the nature of this nature, neither in nor out of workplace. Whilst Noel has been a friend and colleague for several years, I cannot stand by and ignore these allegations. Sexual harassment, abuse, bullying have no place in our industry. Every woman has a right to a safe workplace. Moving forward, I pledge my dedication to this." Which is what should be the ultimate lesson from all of this, isn't it? There needs to be a reckoning in general with men within the entertainment industry, and maybe women as well, in terms of how they place themselves, how they view themselves, how they present themselves. We need to get to a place where you just treat the people that you work with in your industry with just a heightened level of respect. It just needs to happen. We just need to be in a place where, like, once I enter my tattooing world, my skateboarding world, my rap world, my public influencer world, whatever my little niche is, community, I should feel the safest there. It shouldn't be the place where I'm actually going to be at most danger, right? It shouldn't be that if you're a video vixen, you go and do a shoot and suddenly the shoot is the place where you're probably going to get abused more than you'd get in the street. You should be feeling like, hey, once I step on that set, these guys are basically my peers, my colleagues. We're in the same thing together. They should be the ones looking out for me and making it a far better place than the outside world is. Basically creating your own version of utopia within that little sub scene, genre, whatever it may be. That's what we should get a position to being in, because we can't be in a place where, you know, especially people that work within the industry day to day, producers, executives, talent bookers, whatever it is, are just getting abused by people who have all this power and influence, and then no one wants to call it out because they're gaining from it. And then because you're kind of quote unquote nobody, no one's going to believe your account. That must be so mentally draining and hurtful to kind of go through. Right, you clearly are having an incident, you're clearly going through something that's clearly not right, but you can't speak about it. I don't know what that must do to somebody's psyche. That must be horrendous to kind of go through, especially in a sector or in an industry, a sector which is notoriously hard to get into, right? So once you do get into it, you kind of don't want to kick yourself out by saying something too loud and, you know, being difficult, quote unquote. Right, this is the position that we're in at the moment. So people need to really kind of wake up and just, I don't know, man, treat people with respect, men or women, whatever it is, treat them with respect within your scene. Even if you don't necessarily have respect in general, try and be respectful of people that you work with more so than people outside of that. You just have to be. You just have to create that level of safety within these spaces so that everyone can maneuver and do their best work. Because at this, it's just disappointing, isn't it, when you consider who Noel Clarke was and what he represents to film and all that malarkey in the UK. It's just a disappointing part of it. Again, am I happy with the trial by social media? Of course not. Should somebody's entire legacy and career be completely, you know, destroyed by one article that comes out in The Guardian? No. But reading the allegations, how basically he's basically responded to them, basically victim shaming the people that allegedly the crimes against him, the way the industry has responded, you know, everyone's kind of gotten their moral ethical soapbox and started to point fingers. It's just a whole disgusting game. It really, really is. And I don't know, I guess just tell everybody, if you're in this scene, man, keep your head on the swivel. Really do, man. Don't ever assume just because this person seems nice on social that they're going to be nice behind the scenes, because everyone's got some crazy skeletons within this industry, because unfortunately it's set up in a way to exploit and take advantage of people. It really is. It's just the way it is. And they kind of sort of like foster and, you know, and build up these monsters. And then when they do monstrous stuff, they're all there pointing fingers and saying that we never knew. Yeah, right. Yeah, bloody right.